everybody. I know it's really early, like really, really early. So thank you for coming out to our breakfast room. Please enjoy the pastries and free coffee and all that. Our presenter today is Shields Frisch from List and Luxembourg. He's going to be presenting a very comprehensive and really nice presentation on imaging using our devices. So I hope you enjoy. Afterwards, there will be some time for some questions. So if you have questions about anything, just please hold it until the end, and we'll call on you. Just raise your hand. All right. So enjoy, Jules. Thank you.
Thank you for the introduction. Welcome everybody for this early morning session. We'll give you a presentation about AP MALDI coupled to an Orbitrap high resolution mass spectrometry for analysis and imaging. So I'm working at Luxembourg Institute of Science and Technology, which have recently become a European demo lab and application lab for MassTech. So I will give you a few words about our institute, the benefit of coupling this AP MALDI source to an LTQ Orbitrap instrument. I will then show you some analysis and imaging application and workflow. So Luxembourg is a small country sitting between Germany, Belgium and France, and we are a research and technology organization with more than 600 employees, lots of PhD students coming from many different nationalities. We are active in three research and development activities: environment, IT and materials. And I'm working in the materials department, which is active in the following fields: nanomaterials and nanotechnology, polymers, scientific instrumentation, coating technologies, and composite technologies. So to support all these research activities, there is a transversal platform which contains namely the advanced characterization platform, where I'm responsible for the molecular characterization. So within our characterization platform, we have plenty of different characterization techniques which allows us to get analytical imaging. So ranging from very small spot size with electron microscopy, AFM, and elemental dynamics secondary ion mass spectrometry. So we can deal with many different types of materials with different scale of field of view and a different type of information. So regarding molecular imaging, we rely mostly on two instruments. The first one is the time of light secondary ion mass spectrometer. So the benefit of this technique is that it is a highly focused ionization technique. We use a primary ion gun, which can be focused down to 400 nanometers. So in terms of lateral resolution, it's really a high performance instrument. The analyzer is very fast. It's a time of flight. This technique requires no sample preparation, but there are some drawbacks. The ionization is quite strong, so we get a lot of fragmentation of our molecules, and also the analyzer is somewhat limited in terms of mass accuracy and mass resolution. So we wanted to have a softer ionization, so that's why we turned to MALDI ionization. We wanted to have a more reliable identification in our images, having exact mass and structural analysis. So we had in the lab our LTQ Orbitrap that we used for LC-MS application. And of course, we wanted to keep our LC-MS capabilities. So in the past, we used the previous generation of AP MALDI source from MassTech. It was called the PDF Plus version. So it was also an add-on that we could attach on the Orbitrap, removing simply the electrospray and attaching this module. So the laser was provided using an optical fiber, and the focusing was not really suited for high lateral resolution imaging. So we could do some imaging with this PDF source, but of course the spot size was in the range of 100 microns, so not suited for high lateral resolution imaging. So there is now the new version of the AP MALDI source, which is called the UHR for ultra high resolution. So it allows us to keep this benefit of having high resolution characterization of our lipids, for example, in this brain example. But we expect it to have both high resolution in mass, but also high resolution in space, targeting a lateral resolution in the range of 10 microns. So the benefit of LTQ orbitrap instrument is well known for everybody of you who do LC-MS, maybe, with such an instrument. So we have many different type of use of this instrument because it's a combination of two analyzers. We can do a full scan in the orbitrap to get the accurate mass measurement. It's very efficient, but it's slow. We can also use the LTQ independently. It's faster, but of course it's less accurate because it's low resolution analyzer. We can also have targeted analysis using single ion monitoring or MSMS scans in selected reaction monitoring. And we can also combine different modes using the orbitrap, and in parallel we can use the LTQ for MSMS scans in data-dependent or data-independent analysis. This equipment has, of course, an atmospheric pressure interface, so we can use many different ionization techniques, electrospray, APCL, nanospray, or DART. So it's the optimum mass spectrometer for AP-MALDI. AP-MALDI is very flexible, as you can see here. If you just finished your LC-MS run, you just stop your liquid chromatogram, you remove the electrospray module, you attach the capillary extender. You have to cool down your sample to avoid any burn. And then you attach your AP-MALDI source. You close the two brackets. You power on the source, and you can start. So it's really flexible. Within, I think, 25 seconds, it's attached. And of course, we can expect from this new system a high level of performances, both in terms of sensitivity and lateral resolution. So, two modes of operation. Classical approach for multi-spot analysis. So we have the target software, which allows you to control the source. And we use typically Cyex plates with 192 spots. So you can select the spots of interest. And within each of these spots, you can program the motion of the sample holder so that you will not irradiate always the same position. So you can use a raster motion or a spiral motion like this. So you have two examples. You can tune any parameters in terms of velocity of this spiral, distance between the lines, laser frequency, and laser energy. So you can see here that the size of the laser beam is quite slow, because here the distance between the two lines are only 50 microns. So it means that here in this case, the spot size is in the range of 10 microns. So from the mass spectrometer point of view, you will just need to select the analyzer you will use, LTQ or Orbitrap. You can select then the type of scan event you will do. Either a single type of scan event or multiple scan events, so data-dependent analysis or whatever. You select your mass range, and then you start the acquisition. You synchronize the start between the two instruments, either from the tune window in the thermo software or from Excalibur sequence editor. So there is two modes of acquisition. If you have plenty of spots to be analyzed, you can use internal or external synchronization to have either one raw file with all the different acquisitions, so that you can directly click on the different time of acquisition and collect the spectrum of each of them. It can be useful to have all the analysis in the same raw file, because you can directly compare them, and also use the background subtraction feature of Excalibur to remove, for example, the background coming from the peaks of your matrix. The other solution is to have, for each of these spots, a dedicated raw file. So it depends on your habit, let's say. We like to have all the spots in the same raw file to use the background subtraction feature. So one example here, typical example of a mixture of many peptides that we can use for the calibration of MALDI TOF instruments, for example. It's a mixture covering the mass range between 500 and 2000. And we can see here the spectrum of a single scan obtained from a spot size of about 20 microns. So the irradiated amount of molecule is very low compared to the amount of peptides that there is in this solution, about 1 picomole per microliter. So the irradiated amount of molecules is very, very low. So we have a good sensitivity, and of course we have the high resolution, so we have up to maximum 0.7 ppm relative error on the mass measurement of these peptides. So we have quite a good sensitivity. It's typically what we can obtain from a MALDI-TOF instrument, and even in this case, we have a quite a small spot size compared to some MALDI-TOF, where some we have in the Institute of MALDI-TOF, but the spot size is 80 microns. So it's difficult to compare the sensitivity, because in this case, we really sample a low amount of peptides in one single scan. So this is an example of polyethylene glycol that we use quite often to calibrate our MALDI-TOF instrument. So the benefit here is also that once your Orbitrap is calibrated, there is no need to do any additional calibration, because it's like for electrospray, you calibrate and then your instrument can be at maximum of 3 ppm of relative error. So this is very convenient and quite efficient for the detection of, for example, polymers like this. This example is a functionalized lipid, so having a polyethylene glycol moiety here, and the lipid, so it's used for liposome elaboration in our nanotechnology unit. So we see the distribution of intact molecules. So we can get good transmission of all the ions between low mass and the maximum limit of the Orbitrap, which is 4,000. And we have more than 80,000 resolution in the higher mass range. So it's a very powerful technique. So second use of this instrument is, of course, the imaging approach. So we have two ways of producing images. So the first one is using the pixel map mode. So in this case, we will sputter different locations, turning on and off the laser between each positions. So this is an area of 500 micron by 500 micron with 10 pixels per 10 pixels. So the number of pixels is quite low over this small area. So there is another way of working, is the so-called constant speed raster motion. So in this case, we will use the laser continuously during a complete line. So you will produce ions from all these locations continuously, and then the mass spectrometer will sample this line into the desired number of pixels. Okay. So here in this case, it's the same area as before, but with 50 lines, which will be cut into 50 pixel for each of these lines. So if you go closer, this image is taken directly from the software. So you see the different lines very homogeneously separated. And you can see that there is a remaining matrix between these lines, which are separated by 10 microns. So it means that these lines are very, very thin. Again, from the mass spectrometer point of view, you will select your scan event parameters, the type of analyzer, type of scan event, the mass range, and you can synchronously start the acquisition when you will start the target motion. Then, to open your MALDI image, you can either use the Thermo ImageQuest software, which will combine the raw file coming from the mass spectrometer and the position file, which is created by the target software. So these two files will be combined to obtain the MALDI image. Alternatively, you can also convert the raw file plus the XML file into the open source IMZML format, and then you can use it in MSI Reader, DataCube Explorer, Skills, or Metaspace if you want. One example, we use the broken display of the smartphone from a colleague. So we destroyed completely the display to get a small portion of the display. And we could do an image over, again, 500 micron by 500 micron in constant speed raster motion. And then we obtained this image for this specific mass, which is one ingredient of the stack of molecules for red emitting pixels in the display. So we could clearly identify with a high mass the molecules which is located at several positions. So this is an image of it at 10 micron resolution, and this image was done with 50 by 50 pixel. Okay. So in this case, we have used the Orbitrap in a full scan between 150 and 1000 with a mass resolution of 60K. So we did this. We looked also at the spectra at other locations, and we have seen other characteristic masses from different molecules, which are responsible for the emissions of the other colors in the display. So this sample is a quite interesting test sample, because here in this case we probe only the instrumental lateral resolution, because there is no sample preparation using a spray of matrix, which could lead in some cases to a dislocation of molecules. So this is a good test sample for us to evaluate the capability of the source for high lateral resolution imaging. Then an example of a brain section. So we use again the constant speed raster motion. In this case, much more pixels at 30 micron resolution. We use the Orbitrap again in the full scan mode with different resolution. And we could get a scan rate of between 1.5 and 2.5 pixels per second. So this is related to the scan rate of the mass spectrometer. Whatever the type of scan rate you will use with your mass spectrometer, target software will be adjusted to produce ions at the right speed compared to the scan rate of your mass spectrometer. So in this case, we have produced quite a big file after 15 hours of acquisition, and we can obtain very nice images of different lipids. So this is an example of different phospholipids. If you zoom into the spectrum of one single pixel in the brain image, you can see in the phospholipid mass range that there are plenty of peaks. And if you zoom into one mass, for example, you can see that there are some lipids at each mass. So you see clearly the benefit of using the high-resolution mass spectrometer for this application. So the sensitivity is very good, because we don't only see the most abundant phosphatidylcholines, but we can also find phosphatidyletanolamine and so on, all the minor lipids which are meaningful for biological application. And this is again the spectrum coming from one single scan and not an average of the whole tissue, of course. So as I said, you can directly see the imaging data in Thermo ImageQuest, or after conversion into the IMZML format, you can see the same data, of course, with MSI Reader or any other open source software, and you can get in both cases the details around one given mass, showing that if you wouldn't have used a high-resolution mass spectrometer, you wouldn't have been able to separate these three lipids. You can also go down to smaller features in the brain. You can go down to 10 micron lateral resolution, and you still keep enough sensitivity to detect molecules with very narrow mass differences. Another example, just to show how MALDI imaging can be incorporated into a multimodal imaging approach in our lab. So we did a quick example using a cosmetic formulation. I have applied this on my finger. I just touched a clean surface, and we ran a ToughSIMS imaging all over my fingerprint, and we could detect one active ingredient from the cosmetic formulation. So you can get a nice image of this active ingredient, but the mass measurement is not very accurate, because it's a time-of-flight mass spectrometer. So we can only give a mass accuracy with a few tens of ppm relative error. So we localize specific locations in the fingerprint, and we run the AP MALDI imaging after sample preparation using a spray of HCCA matrix, and we could directly overlay these two images, and we see clearly that we have the same type of imaging quality, but in terms of analysis we have a much better mass accuracy. So based on this mass accuracy, we can propose, for example, this mass formula, and there is a very good agreement between the experimental mass spectrum and the theoretical isotopic pattern, so we see clearly the distribution of this molecule. So according to the databases, we can propose these molecules as a potential assignment for this signal, okay? But okay, it can be this formula, but it would be better to be sure that it's really this structure. So what we can do is that we can use the MSMS in the Orbitrap so that we can be sure that it's not only a given mass formula, but it is really this structure, because we know from the databases that we will lose some parts of these molecules in MSMS. So we could have run this MSMS into each pixel analysis during the acquisition. No problem, it is feasible without lowering too much the scan rate. I can show you an example later. But it's one thing to see the intact molecule coming from the formulation. One interesting application is also to see if there are some modification over the time in the composition of a cosmetic formulation. So according to this publication, this molecule can undergo some degradation under UV irradiation. So we wanted to check if in this cosmetic formulation we could see this degradation product, because this formulation was a bit old. It was not a brand new formulation. It was from a colleague, and the cosmetic formulation was quite old. So we could see some of this degradation product exactly in the same location as the intact molecule. So we see this degradation product with a quite good signal-to-noise ratio, even if the relative abundance is less than 1%, we could see this degradation product. So the first one, but also the second one. So this is something which can be very interesting for the cosmetic industry, to see not only the behavior of a cosmetic formulation, but also what happens over time. So interesting to see what happens at the surface of the skin, but more interesting is to be able to evaluate what goes through the skin. And this is something we are quite active in this field with project research with a cosmetic industry. So here is an example of a skin cross-section without any formulation applied on it. But we can see some endogenous lipids from the different skin layers, but also around the hair follicle here. So we can clearly see also what happens to the lipid, where there are some stimulation, for example, UV irradiation on the skin, and see what happens in terms of lipid variation after this UV irradiation, and also how we can protect the skin using UV filters in cosmetic formulations. So that's really what AP MALD can do with a very high accuracy. So to be sure that what we see can be assigned to a given lipid and a specific metabolic reaction of the skin. So this is something that we can apply to the penetration of active ingredient from the cosmetic formulation, but also some of this degradation product that can arise from the exposure of the skin to UV light. And also it can be applied to skin diseases. One last example, just to show how we can combine the different scan events in one given image acquisition. So this is a very simple example. I put the sample holder in the instrument with three ink dots, and I collected the full image of this sample without any sample preparation, so no spray of matrix on top of this sample. So some of these molecules ionize readily without matrix. So we can detect the intact molecule of the main component of each of these ink. So we see the main component from the red, blue, and green ingredients here, thanks to the exact mass measurement of these molecules in the Orbitrap. And during the scan of the Orbitrap at 120K, we have a few hundreds of milliseconds to work in the LTQ for MSMS. So in this case, we have done an MSMS on each of these molecular ions to have a structural confirmation. So here is the selected ion image of each of these molecular ion, and this is the overlaid. And in parallel, in the same acquisition, we can get the scan of the MSMS from each of these molecular ion. So we could do this high resolution imaging acquisition at 120K plus three MSMS scans in each pixel with a scan rate in the range of 1.5 to 2 hertz, so pixel per second. So it's feasible to have not only the full scan MS in each pixel, but also a few MSMS for your targeted molecules. So this brings me to the conclusion. So the AP MALD UHR source provides high performances for MALDI imaging and analysis, both in terms of sensitivity and lateral resolution. It's a very cost-effective add-on module for LC-MS instruments, so it's ideally coupled to high-resolution mass spectrometer. And what was very important for us, that we can keep the flexibility to switch between the different ionization techniques very rapidly, because in the team we have people working on LC-MS and people working on MALDI imaging, and we can switch almost every day if needed between the different configuration. I want to thank people from MassTech for the very interesting interaction that we have, Sue, who is the distributor for this source in Europe, and also my team, who provided me with a lot of help for this presentation. And I want also to thank some of our collaborators who provided the samples and allowed me to show some results today. And thank you for your attention.